You are a terrorist. Yeah, because what's the definition of the word terrorist? Somebody who creates terror in order to bring vulnerability. You want the woman to be vulnerable to you, so you terrify her. You're a terrorist. It's not permitted. Even if the woman has diarrhea of the mouth, you are not permitted to use your fist. Because you know some women too. Listen. And when that diarrhea of the man comes, they used to stand towards the door side. It's bad. By the way, you are not even fit to be a married woman when you insult your husband. You're not fit. Amen. You don't need to be a married woman when you insult your husband. Don't. Okay. Commandment
number five.
Thou shalt honor thy wife and love your husband. Just write the scriptures because my time is short. We're laying the foundation. We'll continue next week, right? Okay. Ephesians chapter 5. Verse 23 to 29, right? 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 1 to 7. Next week, we'll begin by analyzing those two scriptures because they have some rich stuff there. Ephesians chapter 5, verse 23 to 29. 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 1 to 7. We are laying foundation. See, when you go back home, invite every married woman, married man. Those whose husbands or whose wives are not there, let them come. We'll be praying with them. So if there are crises, they have crises in their homes, they can bring the husband's picture or the wife's photo. We shall be praying in this church and intensively praying for marriages. Amen. Let there be stability in marriages because a stable marriage brings a stable home. Mm-hmm. A stable home brings a stable society. Mm-hmm. A stable society brings a stable nation. Mm-hmm. We talk about nation building. Nation building is not possible when the foundation of the home is shattered. Oh. Every nation building begins from the home. Okay, four vital ingredients of a lasting marriage. Take that one and you go home. Four vital ingredients of a lasting marriage. Oh yeah, may God help me to go through. Number one, are you there? Commitment. Somebody say commitment.
Commitment.
Oh, children, let me tell you something. I'll come to that and I'll mention it because I have some myths, mythology. Things that look like truth, but they are not truth. They are just myths. I will show them to you here. But let me say this and give you these four vital ingredients of a lasting marriage. Number one, commitment. Number two, honor. Number three, faithfulness. And number four, trust. I'll come back to this. So number one, commitment, number two, honor, number three, faithfulness, and number four, trust. But get these ones. Some myths about marriage. Myths, M-Y-T-H-S. Myths means some stories that are not true, that they just handed it to us. Some false stories that were believed but were not true. Meet M-Y-D-H-S. Can I give you number one? Number one, false story. Meet. There is equality in marriage. It is commonly believed that in this are mostly the influence of the Western society has made us believe that there is equality in marriage. It's not true. When Oyibo don't destroy own marriage, you won't destroy your own. Thank God, Africa and some other nations, they are not Western nations, still have marriage values. Biblically, the Bible says the man is the head of the family. Head remains the head as Christ is the head of the church and God is the head of Christ. Whether you are financially powerful as a woman, the man is the head. Even if you are a witch, the man is not a witch, that man is a head. If you are a military woman, your husband is the head. If you are a professor, that man is class 7, he is the head. And you know what head means. Head is head. Let me say something. With this hair, you can cut this leg and the man still escapes, creeps and escapes. Do you know that all that controls the entire body is in this head? That's why they punch you for some one place to tap the foot. You just paralyze. Not the foot, they punch him in the head. And any man struggles to defend his head in order to keep the foot and the body. Any woman must struggle to defend the husband and keep him healthy. Because if you get husband, you get future. I'm talking to the married. If you look at that man, in the Igbo culture, they say, if you have a husband, at least when you are doing village sharing of land, you go get portion of farm. Are you getting me? So that which I'm angry. Go on to the book of Isaiah. These women, the way they are looking at me, I'm not happy. Go to the book of Isaiah. Isaiah, because you are playing with that man. Chapter 7. Is that chapter 7? Four. Is it 4 verse 7? Take heed to the wife of. No. Is that scripture? 7 verse 4. No. This scripture that says, and it shall come to pass that 4 verse 1, beautiful. Isaiah 4, 1. And in that day, 7 women shall take hold of one man, saying, we will eat our bread and wear our own clothes. Only let us be called by your name to take away our reproach. Is it your Bible? Yes. That man that you are playing with, the Bible says it shall come to pass. I pray it does not come to pass. But the Bible says it shall come to pass. That 7 women shall lay hold on one man and said, don't buy us food. Don't buy us bread. Don't clone us. We shall clone ourselves. We only want to identify with you that we are wives of so and so. Which means that man you are playing with, 6 others are contesting. Mm-hmm. Amen. If you get your own hole, I'm fine. Okay. There is no equality in marriage. The man is the head. Amen. Number two myth, which is not true. Marriage is for procreation. A lot of people believe that marriage is for procreation. See, and God told them, go ye to the earth and multiply. When God told Adam and Eve, go ye into the world, or he said, and the Lord created them and said, multiply, replenish the earth. They were not yet corporal. And God created man in his days of creation. Let me spoil your theology a bit. God created man in his days of creation. But when after he rested, he formed man from the dust, made a mold, breathed into the mold the man he created. And man became a living soul. So the man was made on another day. The man was created in God in another day. And when Eve, Adam walked through the earth, God was not looking for procreation. God saw loneliness in Eve, in Adam, and created Eve. And said, it's not good for a man to be alone. So, back scripture says, I will make him a helper. The helper does not mean I will make him a subordinate slave. Help meet means somebody who compliments you. Somebody who fills the vacuum. God, Adam could not relate with God because God is a spirit, an incorporeal spirit. God could not feel that gap. An animal could not feel that gap because an animal does not have a spirit, even though it has a body. God had to create somebody, a mold, a woman with a body that has a spirit that lives in a soul, like Adam, for fellowship. Somebody say fellowship. Yes. These are things that your forefathers lied to you, that they marry a woman because they won't born the king. Hey! Africa, mostly we for all. You see them, they come into the house. I said, you give me the crap for the house. Now stick one man in the brain for the house. And the girl is there in the kitchen, struggling to cook for the in-laws. They are there in the parlor. We're not going to take sticker. This family, this one, this family, we're the one. We're the one. This family, we're the one. What kind of nonsense is that? I'll tell you a story. Because a lot of men don't know that they can also be the problem.
True.
I heard that this one happened in a good notice. I heard. One of these caliber of men started creating problems because the in-laws infiltrated their home and they were messing up with this poor girl. For 6 years, she had not been able to conceive. Each time she says, but the doctor said we should come. And in his manly pride, he could not go. And after 6 years, the sister-in-law came and created problem for me, that girl, and the man got offended. He spat her things. He said, go out of my house. And that's how the girl carried her things and left. I have no marriage certificate. That's why I followed the right procedure. When she left, She went around these villages towards, I think, Kake, like that, or Kombone. And since you are unbeliever, that man had only gone to the village, gotten another one, brother one, sir, this one. You know, some mother-in-law select some girls whom they can control. So brought that man, kept in the house. And this girl along the line was doing her little business and then stumbled in the arms of another boy. And the boy was smart. Wasn't long, the boy's caught. So, and this has been about 2 years. This one in the house has not taken in. And this woman was always communicating and asking how house. They kept giving her updates. And you know, women, when it was 6 months, 7 months, getting to 8, she bought this tighten gown with the belly show. She entered into a community. I said, hey, my sister, she will be that man. See, the number became problem. I tell you, my sister. She deliberately walked all around the community. Hey! So that one, the passage number born. That so that other man gets it. I said, this one are evidence. Marriage was not for procreation. Eve was created first for fellowship, secondly, procreation. Mm-hmm. Amen.
Amen.
I said amen.
Amen.
That is why if your wife nobody take in, first of all, she was not a delivery machine. Truly, we pray that she takes in. But the fellowship and the intimacy is the first thing God is looking for. Don't say don't go fry in the leg. Now you be, if you become womb, you will fry up the Old Testament, you the man. Because the way you jump, if you become womb, you will fry intestine. Don't cast a judgment on another man. When you yourself, you're not free. It was just by chance that you become a male. You did not choose to be a male. Amen.
Amen.
So humble yourself. Praise the Lord, somebody.
Hallelujah.
Marriage is not for procreation. So keep your marriage home. Move on. God will bless you with children. Number three, meet. Sex is the ultimate and the crowning effect in marriage. It's not true. A lot of people believe that sex is the ultimate and the crowning effect of marriage. It's not true. Tell your neighbor it's not true. In case you don't believe, tell the neighbor, pastor, say it's not true. Listen, have you seen sex dolls? How many people have seen sex dolls? They prepare, technology has prepared doll baby. As women, with every their organs and everything, and men use it. Whether it's soft like waiting, your baby, not your baby. Are you hearing me?
Yes,
a lot of people think marriage was meant for sex. Look, any brother who keeps falling into sexual immorality and they say, fine woman, give up. That's not the solution. When he marries, he will still jump out. Are you getting me?
Yes.
Marriage was meant for intimacy, comradeship, fellowship, love. Each time I enter into the house, my children are running to me. I say, ah, who's my wife there? I say that for you. At the final, you go. Amen. Because true, he know me, say me, I know my greed. Like, we first prepare the one for old age.
Because all these children you see like that, a few times,
we go to say son of America, say no, and I'm the watchman.
So if it was, are you understanding me? Even at all age, she will be my best friend because now me and he could remain.
So marriage was meant for intimacy, fellowship, togetherness, hearing one another out, helping one another out, being along and around, keeping that warmthness. Sex truly is one of the gadgets to keep that intimacy, but it was not primarily for that. That's why if the bedrock of your marriage is bed relationship, the day trouble starts, you will jump out. And I'll come to that, because some of you, girls, women, because your past, you used to have varying sexual pleasures. You can weigh them. You know which man does it best. Which man carries you to cloud five. Which man does not have everything. Now when you got married to that man who was a virgin and had not been exposed to that rough life, because he cannot do it, while he's on you, your mind is looking on Jay. Yes! No doubt Jay has not left your phone. Why? Why? Why did you tell this man that I'm a sexual expert? Don't marry me. Because you cannot satisfy me. Look how the man tried to go, only struggling to satisfy you. What is that? It was not meant for that. Amen. It was meant for fellowship. That is part of it. Was meant for fellowship. Take the last one and we close for today. The last two. When you marry the will of God, there will be no problems. It's not true. But the cause has, it's true to, it's good to marry the will of God. But if you marry the will of God, there will still be a problem. Because the perfect will of God does not mean the perfect person of God. It's just the perfect will of God. And when you have the perfect will of God and you use the perfect manual of God and follow it, you will have a perfect marriage. God does not bring two perfect people. He only brings his perfect will. Mm-hmm. Are you understanding me?
Yes.
So, that is why even in the perfect will of God, you must work out the marriage. And get this last one. It's a wrong thing to believe God created the woman for the man. No. God did not create the woman for the man. Amen. God created them for one another. The man is there to help the woman is there to help the man. When you leave selfishness, marriage will work. As we start building from today, I want to stop here. As we start building from today, look, I will mention that first point I mentioned about commitment and then I pray for you. A lot of people have troubles in their marriage and they think it's satanic attack. It's not satanic attack. Satan attacks is true. But the philosophy you carry it into the marriage. I will teach you some things about the four kinds of laws. The four kinds of law: Philios, Eros, Stoic, and Agape. I've been teaching some things on temperament, how to balance your home, some things you are blaming the wife on. Some people marry in order to change the woman to their taste, and for 35 years, it has not really worked. I'll give you keys for a successful marriage. Amen.
Amen.
You say, why? My own will succeed. I'm not boasting. By the grace of God, even in the midst of the shaking, amen, we keep going and we keep going and we keep adjusting. You did not marry a perfect person. You only married a perfect being. Praise the Lord. Marriage! Emotion is only part of marriage. Oh yeah, you see this beautiful girl. Huh? Look at me here. You see this beautiful girl. Mama, please stand up. Listen. It comes a time. I'm not talking that some things happen or she delivered or what. Just because of continual closeness, the Eros instinct sometimes die. Sometimes if you've gone to bed concurrently at very close range, oftenly, sometimes the desire dies. It begins to go down. Are you understanding me? Sometimes you refrain for a while and then the emotions are built back. But during that period, it is not emotion that keeps that marriage. It's commitment. Are you understanding me? I am committed to her. I see various beautiful girls as they plenty for this church. Truly, my I am man, my body is yangre. But not to one I be committed to. So marriage is an issue of commitment. Leave that emotional process beside. God is looking for committed men, not for emotional men. Because in life there is always an emotional high and emotional low. But when you take a commitment, I'm pretty. You say, Pastor, have you lost it before? Yes. After a woman, Yes, I've lost it. Not one time, maybe two. But I committed myself to a woman. And so when the lust comes up, I said, hello.
Hi.
You were knocking on the wrong door.
Oh yes.
I committed myself to a woman. While my body is troubling me, this body does not control me.
Oh yes.
My emotions are shaking. Emotions, you are not my full composition. I committed my heart to a woman.
Yes.
If you draw plenty, I run back to my cattle. Are you getting me here? Marriage is honorable and a bed of defile. Warmongers and adulterers, God will judge. Keep emotions by the side. Keep the reasons why your spouse offended you by the side. Whatever the reason, the ones who cause you to fall. I know you quote scripture, the righteous falling seven times. Me and no one slide, talk less of fall, one time. Amen. I know the judgment that is on defaulters of the laws of God. You shall not go unpunished. As we build marriage homes, to you that are not married, I'll pray for you today. God will bring you into your own rightful home. But go back with this, that marriage is commitment. And it's not for children, it's for men. Men give commitment. Children give promises without commitment. Are you getting me?
Oh, yes.
I said, are you getting me?
Oh, yes.
Young girls, when you commit yourself and you pray that you commit yourself to a man who has married you legally, be given to that man. We shall be touching many things in these 4 weeks of marriage. Stand to your feet. My culture. You heard the testimonies of healings and deliverance, breakthroughs and others. But I will never jump on the pew to pray for you when I have not taught you the word of God.
True.
because that is what that which will take you to a greater height.
Amen.
Amen. Pick up your Bible again. Pick up your Bible. Hold it up. Repeat after me. I believe in this book.
I believe in this book.
It is the word of God for me.
Whatever it says
comes to pass.
I trust in it.
It's the voice of my Father.
It is there to bless me.
It is there to guide me. I believe in this book.
I believe in its content.
Keep it down. Whether you're married or not, lift up your hands and pray a prayer. Lord, if you are married, say, Lord, I commit myself. When I mean I commit myself, I take a decision to remain faithful to my spouse. If you are not married, say, Lord, as you raise me and you bring my spouse to me, Lord, I am committed to a man and not to men. I am committed to devote my life and my time and my energy and everything to this man. I make a decision to follow your word and be committed to the one you bring my way. Open your mouth and pray. Pray for that grace. Somebody pray. Seriously, if you're a single brother here, Lord help me as I give myself to you, to be committed to the man, to the girl I'm going to get married to. Help my emotions. Me talking to you, I always pray, oh God, help my emotions. Help my emotions. Pray. You're always been by me, always been with me, always been upon me. Kabosha leka, leka baneha. I want to still pray for the singles. Just keep the hands up, close your eyes, and get concentrated.